भगवान बाबा के कमल चरणों में मेरा कोटि कोटि प्रणाम. I can see a lot of smiling faces. There's a lot of happiness on everybody's faces. And we have reasons. It is a Sunday afternoon. All of you have come here. I can say a few things for sure. All of you love Swami. Yeah. All of you are here to get some joy. And lastly, most importantly, all of you love Bhajans. Yeah? Does everybody love Bhajans?
Yes.
Yeah. The bliss from Bhajans. And I'm really fortunate today because I'm here to introduce a senior brother, an extremely nice human being, Swami's student, and a great Bhajan composer. Probably one of the legends of all times in the Shri T.V Hariharan category. Yeah. When I actually, you know, look back, I think I remember one of the times I was having this conversation. He, Bhagwan ne bahut talents diye hain, lekin aur har talent jo hota hai na, kisi ke paas agar ho, duniya mein bahut tarah ke talents hote hain. Kuch talent aise hote hain aap जो आप अगर चाहे आपके पास हो ना हो लेकिन अगर आप कोशिश करो तो आप सीख सकते हो. जैसे मेरे को बोलना नहीं आता था इतने सारे लोगों के सामने खड़े होके, मैंने कोशिश करी, आज मैं आपके सामने खड़े होके बात कर पा रहा हूँ कॉन्फिडेंस. लेकिन एक टैलेंट ऐसा है जो भगवान की ग्रेस से ही मिलता है, या तो आपके पास है या नहीं है, आप उसके लिए कुछ कर नहीं सकते. और वो टैलेंट है म्यूजिक का टैलेंट. आप कोशिश करके इम्प्रूव कर सकते हो अपने आप को, लेकिन जो भगवान की ग्रेस है कि अगर आपके पास है तो है. एंड वी आर रियली फॉर्चुनेट टुडे बिकॉज वी हैव अमिस्ट अस जिनको वो टैलेंट भगवान ने दिया, जिन्होंने उनका टैलेंट भगवान ने उनका टैलेंट और रिफाइन किया. उनके लिए उनके गुरु भी भगवान श्री सत्यसाई बाबा थे और भगवान भी भगवान श्री सत्यसाई बाबा थे. वी रियली फॉर्चुनेट टू हैव अमिस्ट अस श्री हरिहर ब्रदर. In the year 1979, जब मैंने ज्वाइन किया तब था year 1993. कुछ यहाँ पे स्टूडेंट्स बैठे हुए हैं जिन्होंने ज्वाइन किया 2005 में. जब हम 2005 में कोई स्टूडेंट ज्वाइन करता था वो हमें कहता था तुमने 2000 में किया तुम कितने लकी हो. और जब मैं 2000 में मैंने पास आउट किया तो मैं ब्रदर प्रसन्नजीत को बोलता था आप 93 में थे आप कितने लकी हो आपको इतने चांसेस मिले. 93 के स्टूडेंट 85 वालों को ऐसे कहते थे. और ये सोचो ये तो पहले स्टूडेंट थे प्रशांति निलियम में जो फर्स्ट बैच था. ही वाज फ्रॉम दैट. तो 1979 में इन्होंने स्वामी के कॉलेज में ज्वाइन किया. ही फिनिश्ड हिज बीएससी एंड ही वाज रियली फॉर्चुनेट दैट स्वामी टोल्ड हिम यू बी विद मी एंड वर्क इन द एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ब्लॉक ऑफ श्री सत्यसाई यूनिवर्सिटी. इन्होंने वहां पर 2 साल स्वामी की सेवा करी. इनफैक्ट जब ये स्वामी की सेवा कर रहे थे इनको एक स्पेशल ड्यूटी मिली थी कि स्वामी का डोर सेवा करने की. स्वामी का डोर स्वामी खोलना, स्वामी का डोर बंद करना. और वो ड्यूटी स्वामी सिर्फ अपने मोस्ट ट्रस्टेड डिवोटीज को ही देते थे. आफ्टर वर्किंग फॉर 2 ईयर्स इन स्वामी 3 ईयर्स इन स्वामी यूनिवर्सिटी ब्रदर हरिहरन ज्वाइंट one of the biggest pharmaceutical companies in India at that point in time and worked there for 3 years. Selfishly speaking, 3 saal ke baad unhone socha ki main ye pharmaceutical company chhod deta hu. Main selfishly isliye bol raha hu kyunki agar inhone wo decision nahi liya hota to jo 250 bhajans inhone compose ki hai aur jinki wajah se hame bliss mili wo bliss hame nahi milti. So He dedicated his life after that day in singing Swami's glory in singing Swami's bhajan and spreading Swami's mission from in not just India. He has traveled across the globe, and like all devotees, Swami tests his devotees. It is not that, you know, he will give everything. जब इन्होंने अपनी जॉब छोड़ी तो फर्स्ट टू थ्री इयर्स इनको स्ट्रगल भी करना पड़ा. इन्होंने काफी स्ट्रगल किया, लेकिन ही वॉज फर्म इन हिज डेडिकेशन एंड कमिटमेंट टू स्प्रेड स्वामी नेम, सिंग स्वामी ग्लोरी. एंड इट इज नॉट ईजी टू कंपोज 250 भजन्स ऑफ स्वामी. इट इज ओनली व्हेन स्वामी ब्लेसिंग्स आर ऑन यू एंड स्वामी गिव्स यू दैट special talent that those 250 bhajans come. It's not just talent, it's actually hours and days and years and months of regular practice day on day that you reach these heights. So we are really fortunate, and we would like to listen to the joy that he has spread all across the world today with us by sharing his experiences with Swami and with all of us. So we now welcome Brother Hariharan to come. Brother Atul will also now join Shri Hariharan, brother, on the tabla.
Pranams. And the lotus feet of the Lord Bhagavan. Brother Kapil, you bore me a lot. All of us know we are nobody. His love talks about His glory, makes us sing His glory. करो ये प्रार्थना तेरे चरणों में वंदना, स्वीकार करो ये प्रार्थना तेरे चरणों में वंदना. हर काम को पूरा करूं, हर दिल में खुशी भरूं. हर काम को पूरा करूं, हर दिल खुशी भरूं. स्वीकार करो ये प्रार्थना तेरे चरणों में वंदना. मुझे न हो अहम की भावना, न हो ईर्ष्या यातना. मुझे न हो अहम की भावना, न हो ईर्ष्या यातना. ये प्रार्थना तेरे चरणों में वंदना. साफ हो मेरे हर कदम, साथ देना साई हर कदम. साफ हो मेरे हर कदम, साथ देना साई हर कदम. स्वीकार करो
It's not only capital of India, it is also capital of Bhajans. Beautiful Bhajans like Bolo Bolo, Sabil Bolo, Allah Akbar. I can name at least 250 Bhajans or more. And Hey Ramanarayana, like that we can go on and on and on and on. These are the real Namdev Tukarams of Swami, who instilled that devotion in every bhajan singer today existing in the world. If Swami is utilizing, I am sure nobody would have composed by themselves. Swami puts the words, tunes and the emotion behind everything, and then it comes through their body, and today we are grateful to all of them. Why I asked all of you to sing is Bliss of Namasmarana. It is not because of any individual. It is because of all of us together brings the bliss of Namasmarana more than any individual at all. Today I would like to associate the bhajans and also with our lives. I won't say my life. Bhajans and our lives, that has become inseparable part in our lives. In every Sai devotee throughout the globe, they are mad after Namasmarana. We will dwell on few things, but as rightly I want to say, the composers of Delhi, from Bengal, Kalyan Chowdhury, Devanath Mukherjee, Master Moshai, like that lots of people from Trichy, Tiruchirappalli, like that 100, 200, 300 people Swami has worked on them, brought them here, gave us all the most wonderful Namasmarana to us. Today we breathe in, breathe out because of that Namasmarana. Otherwise, we would have been nil if this Purna Avatar wouldn't have taken birth in this planet Earth during our time. What would have been our life? We cannot even dream. On a Sunday afternoon, all of us have assembled to think about His glory, to meditate on His glory, and be grateful to Him for bringing us all together. We cannot say, this is Delhi Sai Devotee, this is Bangalore Sai Devotee. Sai has created every one of us. We have become one universal family. That Vasudeva Kutumbakam, which was a dream before, has become practicality because of Purnavatar, our beloved Bhagavan Satya Sai Baba. So all of us, in gratitude, we clap, also offer our pranams to Swami. I was wondering, Swami left His physical frame in 85 years, whether He finished His avataric mission or not. One day I was pondering over. When I was pondering over, I am 58 years old, many of you must be more than me. What have we achieved in our life? Absolutely nothing. Swami, by the age of 53, had university, at the young age, hospital, educational institution, everything, and millions of people around the globe got inspired. And what did He do? Today, I want to contemplate that how His Namasmarana could really fulfill the avatarhood. Swami comes and stands in front of us, robe touching our face, flowing, and then His padam under our feet when He is just inserting it. With all the students, I am sure all of you will agree, and with all the devotees also, He used to stand like that. We are young boys. We would like to see the world. We want to do so many things. But when we are with Swami, did we think about the world? Never. Why? How can the mind be banished so easily when the mind control is so difficult for every one of us? How can He vanquish the mind? That is the power of love of that Purnavatar. The moment He comes and stands in front of us, we don't even remember our name, where from we come, what we are doing, nothing we remember. If He is standing in front of us, we are doing Father Seva like this, He gives one hit, hey, Dhanupata, remove your hand. But we know very well He is telling just like that. So we would like to catch His feet more thing, because that's the ultimate experience any being, anybody who has done tapas for millions of years, who cannot achieve that, easily we got. What happens when He is standing? We forget ourselves. How much we forget ourselves? Total evacuation of mind. So a bhajan comes. Sai Sundari, Parama Manohara Sai Sundari. Total evacuation of mind with no tapas, no japa, no jhana, nothing. We know nothing about meditation. Very fact, Swami is in front of us. The mind is vanquished. Parama Manohara Sai Sundari. By standing, vanquishing the mind, what happens? Sukh Bharsani Bhava. It gives so much of what is Sukh. It's not enjoyment of life. Where there is no Dukh, that is Sukh. If we are attached to the word, Dukh will be there. Sukha matlab ye hai. Not worldly style of enjoyment. It is where there is no dukkha at all. So, sukh barasane bala. And from Swami's word, because Swami has sung so much, bhajan se manu ko sajan banakar. So if you would have taught us, say, Bhagavad Gita or something like that, first itself, then people cannot understand, they would have run away. But he taught the bhajan, so easily everyone, today, Sai Bhajan, four lines, everyone, Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, the way it was sung, very powerful, very easy, fulfilling, excellent. That type of bhajan is a manko. When we sing bhajan, absolutely world is not existing within us. Bhajan se manu ko sajan banakar bhakti marg vardhan diya. He has given that boon of bhakti. Till at least I know Swami. Before that, I go to temple, I worship, I offer my prayer. But that experience of being one with God was never there. Until I met Swami, until I had darshan of Swami, until when he spoke something very softly, even if it is going to be chiding also, we'll think Swami talked to me. Even if he says Dunna Pota, we are very happy because he talked to us. Because the voice is full of love and sweetness. That was it. So bhajan se manu ko sajan banaka. Bhakti Mark Vardandiya, Kriya Vatari, Leela Vatari, Bhakti Vilari Sai. This bhajan, I don't know, I'll try. Can you all give chorus without beat first? We'll try. Then I will share my experiences of my life.
Parman Manuhar Sai Sundari Sai. we'll sing from Param Mangala. Together.
Hari Hari.
Avataric mission was to see to it the path of devotion, path of karma, path of jnana, all are same. Because all needs, devotion means even if you do a duty, you need devotion. If you do a duty, you need jnana, you need the intelligence to do that. Similarly, for bhakti also other two has to be there. For jnana also other two has to be there. So he gave that to every one of us. Today, we are living in his presence without even missing him for a second, because he gave Namasmarana to every one of us. Not knowing, when I joined Swami's college, suddenly Swami asked me to play harmonium. Suddenly he asked me to sing. When we start singing, I want to say in a nutshell, opportunity to sing in front of Swami is most important. So we enjoy singing in front of Swami. We counted the blessing a lot. We thoroughly enjoyed every day, morning and evening. But that was the beginning of Namasmarana. Still nothing was achieved. Because you are singing in front of Swami, you are satisfied that you are singing in front of Swami. Whether bhajan is to be sung in the bhajan and then after that have the satisfaction, or is there anything addition to that? Lots of things are there which I didn't realize at that time, because it was only a student and Swami. There is no life apart from Swami for the student. So that was more than enough, because living with God. Now living with God has to be permanent. Not only in Prachanilayam, not only in Vrindavan, not only in the Sai Center. Whether we live to that every second in our life. So that was what Swami revealed to me slowly. What a Namasmarana can do in life. Anybody, not Hariharan. Every one of us. First his duty is, we are somewhere, he brings all of us, gives us the opportunity to sing bhajan, gives us the opportunity to probe more in bhajan. In bhajan, we have bhava, raga, tala. You must have heard about bhajan, what to do, how to do, what all the way practice. Today I am not touching any of those things, because every one of us know that. I want to find out within myself, what did this Namasmarana did to me or does to all the devotees? What has it done? Its tune is there, the rhythm is there, then the words are there. Everything has to be in coordination with each other, then only bhajan is so effective. Similarly, after bhajan, we go back, we have our life, home life, society life, so many things. Whether this bhajan gives that peace for 24 hours of the day, every day in our life, does it give? Yes, it gives. That we have to see to it, we have to drive that. How we use that peace or that silence, or that ananda. After singing bhajan, after listening to wonderful bhajans, we go out and immediately forget this vibration and then we lose it. If we think bhajan is in raga, tune, tala, everything, our life also should have that type of peace. We have to unite. If you are a family man, if you are with family, you should see you are in tune with your family, with your children, and then your society at large. When you go like that, then your life also becomes a bhajan. What Namasmarana did in my life is, Swami, after singing bhajans for 5.5 years in Prachanilayam, I told Swami, I want to go to Bangalore, Swami. Swami told him, I have given you accommodation. I am keeping you with me. You are singing morning and evening. Why do you need to go? When bliss is there, why do you want to leave that and go? But I know very well, this is something Swami's blessing in physical presence, to be in that state is nothing very difficult, nothing very great. Can I have that at all time? Having sung, it is not that I am going to sing 100 years in front of Swami. One day or the other I have to stop. But am I able to hold that bliss and peace within myself? So I told Swami, with you, I have no need in this world. I am perfect. This is easy. But when I physically leave you, I want to know whether I live with you. I know you live with me, but I live with you or not. That awareness, do I have or not? I want to know. So I have to go, I told. After much persuasion, Swami told, yes. Then he gave prasadam. Then I was leaving. I came to Bangalore. Before I am leaving to Bangalore, on the February 14, 1984, we call it as Valentine's Day today. And I was leaving my Valentine. And I am going. So that day I sang Sai Prem Deshanti Dev for the first time, that bhajan. I was crying. In those days voice used to be high pitched. I used to shout a lot because, you know, maddening, that was different. Now with the age, calm down also. So after singing three speeches Swami put, but whenever I open my eyes, Swami will turn this side and that side, he won't look at me. When I close my eyes, he will look at me. And I am crying and singing Sai Prem Deshanti Reyanam. I am singing that. After that, I came out, stood in the veranda near the last pillar in Prashanti Mandir. Suppose Swami is going out that day to Gokulam or something. In those days he used to do, after darshan interview, after bhajan, he used to go to Gokulam by car. So I thought, you know, I will wait near the pillar, have one more darshan of Swami. If possible, if he will come near me, because car comes near the last pillar. So students, you know, we observe and absorb and then do all those things. So I was waiting near that pillar and there was no trace of Swami's coming, but suddenly door opened, Swami's coming. I'm telling Swami, you are not looking at me. I am leaving to Bangalore. At this time I need all your blessing. And somebody comes home and then they are going. You have to give smile and sit up, not with a serious note. Swami, please bless me. You don't have to do anything. Look at me, smile at me. I take it as a blessing and then I leave Prashanthi. I was thinking, but Swami comes out, walks, catching the rope, putting the head down, adjusting the hair like this, and then doing this, and he is walking. Swami, please, Swami, look at me. Once, please, please, please. He comes near me because car is there, he has to take a turn. I thought, Swami, this opportunity I lose, whole life, my life is gone. Please, please, how much he responds. When we pray like that, he responds immediately. So immediately, you know, when he's coming there, near, 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 the moment he came near the face of mine, just lifted the head up. My life is made. And he asked, "Yeni chestu now Bangalore lo velli? What will you do in Bangalore?" Now I got full vigor back, because as I was physically close to Swami, how free I thought. That strength came. I told Swami, computer science. Computer science. Swami says, "Padapothunnava, are you going to sing?" I want to tell him, man, because of your grace I am singing in your physical presence. I won't be accepted elsewhere. Of course, I will sing bhajans everywhere. But my life is going to be computer science. I will become an engineer, work somewhere, do something, take care of the family, all those things, you know. Be imagined. There where Lord teaches you, whether He plans your life or you plan your life. So if you are Padaputunava, I told no Swami, I am going to do computer engineering. Again he told, Padaputunava, little, strongly, I told no Swami, computer science. Manchita Vali Padma, go sing well. But my dear brothers and sisters, I didn't understand a word out of that. I thought, I say computer science and he is saying go and sing his glory. What is this? Anyhow we will sing his glory everywhere. We are all here, we are all singing his glory. He will be singing. Why should he say that especially? Little did I realize, after finishing my computer science course, later I joined as a marketing sales executive. I got married in May 1988, 29th of May, and 1989, January 8th, I went to office as usual with full suit and tie and everything, with a, you know, rotating chair, you sit and then you keep on, already world is rotating around you, you also start rotating opposite. So you see where you are landing. But heart says, serve one master, because I am mad after Bhajan. When I am inspired by Swami's name, it's not only Namasmarana, Namaruchi, taste. The moment we hear the name of the Lord, whether it really affects our heart, whether it is some airport, suddenly somebody comes and tells, I know, finish. That's the power of Namasmarana. That Namasmarana. So I thought I will work, but suddenly my heart says, leave. Straight away I left resignation. On personal ground, I resigned. And I am married for 6 months. And child, next will be child. That process is on. Here I am suddenly deciding and then leaving the job. When I left the job, my executive wife was a very nice man. Hariharan, what's the problem for you are leaving job? I told no. I want to only sing bhajans, I don't want to work here. Did you get any other job, better position? I don't know. That means you are from a rich family? I don't know. How will you eat? I told, from birth till today, somebody has been feeding me. When you take birth, mother has fed you. Later, father hands the money and he feeds you. Somehow you had your food. Somehow you lived your life. Why suddenly doubt that this is what is going to pay you or take care of you? I thought the Lord who has created, He has a purpose. He has planted every one of us in this planet Earth. He has got a purpose from every one of us, sharing His love to humanity. When we are going to share His love to humanity, naturally we are automatically taken care. Where is doubt? There is no doubt. I boldly said and came home very early. And imagine a wife, 6 months married, believing me, this fellow is going to be a very stable fellow. And then I come back home very early. And then she asked, how come you are early, so early? I told her I left my job. As though I didn't like your food. So I told her I have left my job. Then immediately she told, very good. I was really shocked. Okay, she said, very good, you know. She said, very good. That word is again Swami's word too. That gives the confidence. Okay, underwent lots of things with nothing. I lived for 4 years. When I am living better, did I any day went without food? No. Didn't I have cloth? Yes. Did I sing bhajan? Yes. How many hours? 18 hours per day. Then I'll take the army, go to the temple, sit there, keep on singing, so that you know you don't feel, you don't have money, you cannot do this, you cannot do that. Keep on singing, you are happy. Come lunchtime, something will be there, eat and again go back. Or sit at home and sing. So much of power, so much of peace, felt that I am the emperor of the world. I never felt I didn't have this, I didn't have that. How to do this, what to do that, nothing. Who gives that strength? Swami. How he gives that strength? Namasmarana. That Namasmarana. With that bliss of Namasmarana, we don't feel hungry. We don't feel we are poor. We feel we are very rich because we are having Swami's bhajan in our tongue. It dances. So that's it. We are peaceful. Life started. I have shared this in many places, but still I want to share with Delhi devotees. Relatives one by one come. Why did you leave the job? Why do you make your child and wife suffer? Everything. Are you Jesus? Are you Balamurali Krishna? Are you Muhammad Rafi? I told they are also creation of God. अपनी जगह है सबके लिए ये दुनिया में तो अभी मैं यहाँ पर बैठ रहा हूँ एक्चुअली ईच वन ऑफ यू आर कैपेबल ऑफ सिटिंग हियर बट नाउ दिस स्टेज स्वामी हैज गिवन मी ईच वन ऑफ अस गॉट अवर स्पेस दिस स्पेस बट सर्टेनली आई टोल्ड व्हेन गॉड हैज गिवन ऑल ऑफ देम समथिंग गॉड आल्सो गिव्स मी आल्सो अ प्लेस बिकॉज आई एम क्रिएटेड बाय हिम आई एम लव्ड बाय हिम I was made to do all these things by him, not by anybody else. Nobody taught me anything. Nobody encouraged me. Swami, in our time, bhajan group means, you know, Ashok Mehta is there and all of you are there. In our time, student singers means it is not that student who knew music building. No. Suddenly comes and selects, Swami selects. Hey, you sing bhajan. When he says you sing bhajan, you may not know anything about bhajan. Very fact, when Swami's command is coming to you straight, that love, that power has entered our heart. Whatever we sing will be powerful. Whatever we sing will be full of love. It's not the genius of us. It is the love of Swami. But all we are singing, whether we should know, we are not genius. It is love of Swami which is making us do all these things. So I told Swami has created, Swami is taking care, he will do. It was the Deepavali time, recently Deepavali happened, so I want to. I was living in a space, 10 by 10 room. There was no kitchen. My wife created a temporary kitchen. We were living, suddenly all relatives coming. And then they say, what are you going to do for Deepavali? I told same thing, what I have been doing till today. What else I will do? What is so special? I told whatever I have to do. No, did you get new clothes for me? Did you get new clothes for your wife? At least for your daughter did you get new clothes? But because, you know, I am a free man. I didn't have anything. If you have something, then you have to do all these things. If you don't have anything, you are happy. One thing you are happy, nobody will disturb you. When you don't have anything, nobody will come here. Live the life of incognito and you can contemplate more on the Lord because nobody is bothered about you. You and God live together all alone. Beautiful face of life. Not even one day, one of my friends are, hey, how can you be happy? I told, what can destroy our happiness? We are always happy. What can, unless you want to be sad yourself and regretting, oh, I should have done that. A human mind, when you have experience in front of Swami, your mind is destroyed. Why don't we continue? Parama Manohara Sai Sundara Vite. And when he has destroyed the mind, why should bring back the mind and worry, brood over? It's we. After experiencing Swami, if you do that, do we not belittle Swami? Are we not belittling Swami? Having experience in thorough bliss, pure bliss in the physical presence, after that you say that is physically, this is something, what is, how can we differentiate between physically, spiritually, all those things? Is omnipresent, omnipotent, omniscient? Then how can we talk only here like this, only there like this? No, at all times he is here. Now he is here. He is listening through all of you, he is talking through all of me. He's doing everything through all of us. Each one of us are playing. It's all of our vibration together makes him sit here. never worry. So Deepali time, all the lotus came. Hari, don't you think you are so irresponsible? You put your wife and child to this type of thing. What type of karma they did? Because yes, they have done that karma. That's why she's my wife and that's my child. Yeah, we have to accept. But understand, power of God is, do you think your Sai Baba will break the roof and give you money for Deepavali? And my house is so small, rental house, poor owner. I told her, yeah, I won't even pay the rent. And immediately I told him, my God won't break others. He is loving, he is helpful. He will come via the main door and give whatever he has to give me, he will give. I was telling a girl called Vani, her father Ramachandra was singing in the Divine Presence in Vrindavan. She is coming because there are 10 houses, all small, small matchbox houses we were all living. So, she comes, she says, uncle, there is a letter for you. That letter I told, it's written in Kannada. I don't know Kannada to read and write. I told, my dear Veena, this is not for me, Vani. Somebody else, nobody writes to me. First of all, note the letter comes to me. On top of that, in Kannada one letter is absolute unbelievable thing. I told, no, it's not for me, I told. And immediately she says, no, uncle, your name is written. I told, since it is in Kannada, you know Kannada, better you open the cover. Then she opens the cover. There is a covering letter from government of Karnataka saying that for your invaluable service for Kannada language and Karnataka state, I am already a jobless fellow. What value is going to be for invaluable service you have done to Karnataka state and Kannada language, which I cannot read and write. If I say I am a Hindi poet, how much it will be like? Same thing in Kannada also. So I told him, no marking. Covering itself is totally covered. So please watch. No, no, uncle, it's for you. Then she is telling that, and behind is a demand draft for a big money from government of Karnataka before Deepavali. My God walks inside through the big door. And he is so loving, he responds to you on this part. That is why Sai Mera Tumhare, Deenu Ke Tum Pran Sakha Prabhu. On this part, prana sakha, on this part. If you call your friend, can I have a lakh of rupee for 1 week? Then, oh, I have today. Actually, you know what happened? Prana sakha is on this part. That is why. After that experiences, one after the another. After all, people believe in the material world. And if materiality is what going to count our life, when the Lord of the universe possessing the universe, what is this small morsel of materiality? Very easy. We don't want to ask him that. We have come here for different purpose. When we have that type of awareness that Swami is with me, he is going to take care of you. Why should I ask him, you do this, you do that? How many days for water? First you will say money, then you will say promotion, then job, then bungalow, then car, then children marriage, da, 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 then grandchildren marriage, then great-great-grandchildren. Where is the time for God? How much he has done? When he never thought about himself for a second, when he has always thought about every one of us all the time. Students during alumni meet, I remember 2009, 2010 and all, 2002 onwards, Swami will see, we have more than 20,000 students, something like that, passed out, or at least 10,000 students. How many people will be there for alumni meet? 5. But Swami, you know, oh, my children has come. give them that, do this, do that, everything he does. He means, you know, those who have not come in Catholic, those who have not thanked us for the work we have done. This fellow is ungrateful. I did so much for him, he never even said thanks to you. That is we. When are we going to develop that vision of Swami? Universal love. Love. One person comes also, he feels so proud. Oh, my child is here. I'm sure that many of you who have been coming to Puttaparthi and think, the moment Swami sees, he will give that familiar. Oh, here come. No, first look will go a little, you know, broad, then give a smile. Tell me how many of us, when we enter somebody's house, they will give that happy look. Not that Swami. And now, here we are, so many people are there. Throughout we are, how many people are there? Swami has given time to so many people, talking to them, giving them interview. Do you think humanly it is possible? If we count the time, if I or you have to give so many interviews and talk to so many people, I don't think we would have touched their life. Swami has done that. And each one of us have got that type of experience. If I say one experience, each one of you starts saying experience. Each one from the whole world saying, sharing the experience. You are at last. So much. This Deepavali episode was the first beginning that my nearby family could realize, yes, this fellow is protected by God, not by any human. Later, what happened? Every one of them turned a Sai devotee. We need not tell people, I am a Sai devotee and this is my ideal. They said, we just keep quiet, be silent, and then show your faith, your love to your Lord within yourself. Be happy, be blissful, be satisfied. Count yourself, you are the most blessed fellow in this world. When we can do like that, each one of us will be powerhouse here. Imagine throughout the world we create this type of powerhouse with faith. What a world to live. It will be Goloka. It will be like Gopikas and Gopas with Lord Krishna. In the absolute bliss, there is no selfishness at all. Easily we can create. Easily we can create. Because here Lord has not only covered only bridge people, he has bridged the whole world with himself. And all of us are together, we can create that type of feeling that, you know, totally losing ourselves in the divine glory. We may be working, we may do business, we may do so many things in our life, but our heart's true love is Swami. Otherwise we won't be here. We learn 1001 work at home. We are here because, you know, our heart has got itself entangled to only Swami, nothing else. That's why we are. This is one small episode. Like that, hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of episodes went on happening. So what happened? First bhajan, singing Namasmarana, singing in the divine presence. Then come out in the world, sing bhajan. Then devotees are happy. Then later you start analyzing what it has done to you. Whether it has cultivated your heart towards purity or not. Yes, yes, yes. Because Swami addresses every one of us as the Prematma Surupalaras. Though we don't realize, but he went on addressing us embodiments of love. Should we not give value for that? Are we living in the path of love? What bhajan creates is our attachment towards that Lord, our love towards that Lord. That means love has already sprouted in our heart through bhajan. So when the love has sprouted in our heart through bhajan, what is that? You see anybody you love. You see anybody you don't criticize. Because love doesn't know any mistake of others. Because Swami never saw any mistake in us. Did he ever see any mistake in us? Never. When we do mistake in bhajan, That time, you know, he will put both hands like this and he will do this and he will do. Devotees watching, they say, how lucky this one, how nicely he is singing. That time you would have made mistake actually. I remember in one of the programs, Swami gave 2 months training. 2 months training, morning and evening training for one bhajan. And how you will select? Okay, you come and sing, you come and sing everything. Then you will tell Asami Bhat, you sing in Telugu. And I am a Tamilian from village. I only know my Tamil, no other language. Till the day before he was talking to me in Tamil. But when he wants to tell me to sing in Hindi, he said, oh, Anuturota ji Tamil, Anuturota Bhajan, Tumo Gao. My Hindi is so. But Swami gave that confidence. And what he will do every day, he will say. And today you sing a line, then he will correct you. Next day, some other correction. Next day, some other. 2 months you spend every morning and evening, two hours with Swami. It's more to spend time with Swami more than our singing. After everything program comes, they were all there sitting on the stage. That day, Puttaparthi, we have yearly program, but that day somewhat got delayed. So all of us throats are dried, everything is gone. So now we have to present the program, students program, convocation program. In the front line, all the people are sitting. All musicians, this side Bhimshin Joshi, so many singers. This side, M.S. Balakshmiamma, P. Sushila, P. Leela, all those people. On top of that, there are innumerable singers who are sitting there in the crowd. Swami will sit like this on the stage with us. On par with us, he will sit. I didn't know what is the reason he said. I thought, oh, Swami is giving good support to us. That's all. I didn't know the reason. That day somehow, we all did something or the other. And he taught me some ala pandal, I went fat. Because I am used to seeing Swami and singing. Now I am sitting more than 1 lakh people sitting opposite to me. I had this stage fright. I should have thought about Swami, but I opened my eyes. I thought, oh my God, this many people. Finished. I couldn't start at all. Then intelligently I stopped the ala which Swami taught me. Incidentally, I have the audio clip. How Swami is teaching the ala. Not today. I don't do any PowerPoint presentation. One thing is, technically I am very weak. Number two, I find power is also him and point is also him. No one will have any PowerPoint. So with all these things, you know. So I am singing and that time Swami is showing like this, everything and people are in place. Seeing Swami because they are not. But at the same time, they know this fellow Hariharan is singing also. So Swami is enjoying his bhajan. So everyone is so happy and after the program, Swami went to everyone. Of power, some day, that, everything. Then Swami told my students. Same Swami came onto the stage, and all of you know, Mr. Andrew was taking photography those times. He was saying, Swami is coming, putting shawl, and he is telling smilingly, because photograph. He is smilingly, Anni poyindra, everything play of ego. Smiling. That photographer is saying, Swami is telling smilingly to students, he is talking. And immediately, the photographer uncle missed it. Hey, Swami, talk to you something. I told that's between me and him. He will also teach you right thing at the same time. In front of everyone, he sees to it, you are a step. And such confidence during college days Swami has given. How can we come out and then lose that confidence? Always we have to remember what all Swami has done to us. Whether that power, that confidence still we hold on. If we are holding on, that means we are experiencing him all the time. If we don't, that means we have lost him. Though he is with us, we are searching, we should not. Have the faith, yes, he is always. Imagine in student days, or as devotees when we went, he has done so much to us. have that faith, then the Namasmarana bliss we can enjoy. Bliss of Namasmarana means that name is so sweet, we don't have to beautify it more. Parama Manohara Sai Sundaran, you can see beauty only when the mind is clear, otherwise you will criticize everyone. Even if somebody is beautiful also you will criticize. If mind stops existing, then you will appreciate everything, you will find everywhere beauty. That's why Parama Manohara Sai Sundaran. If you have enjoyed during college days, that same vibration we have to carry on. No matter what is coming in between in life, keep on evolving. Swami takes care of me. Happy faith. Yes, he is taking care. And at all times, I am sure each one of us must experience any trouble, any difficulty comes, Swami, he turned. Does he respond or not? Yes. Any time he responds to us, when he is responding to us, why should we have any doubt or thinking and confusion? Nothing. We are all highly blessed. It's not Hariharan. It is not one person. All of us are highly blessed. Have this conviction in our life. I am living with Swami. I am totally satisfied in my life. Still something which is not happening, don't brood over. Because he knows what should happen, what should not happen. So let us not keep our priority to Swami. Let us have expectation leads to disappointment. Acceptance leads to satisfaction and bliss. That acceptance we have to. When he is taking care of us, we just accept. You are giving something, okay, aisa pura khana hai plate mein, thoda sa karela ka bhi sabzi ho jaye, wo bitter hai. No, no, ye bitter hai, ye brahmarpanam hai, iske liye main nahi keh sakta hoon. ब्रह्मार्पण जाने के लिए कह सकता हूँ, बादाम रोग के लिए कह सकता हूँ, मगर ये करेला के लिए तो मैं ब्रह्मार्पण सॉरी. वी डोंट डू दैट. वी डू ब्रह्मार्पण फॉर एवरीथिंग. लाइफ ऑल्सो इज सेम थिंग. एवरीथिंग तेरा तुझको अर्पण. हम तो आरती गाते हैं, तेरा तुझको अर्पण, क्या लाओ मेरा, अगर पूरा मेरा है तेरा कुछ नहीं है, ऐसा होगा. सो वी हैव टू हैव दैट. There are two parts. Everything is yours. Nothing is mine. It's not for theory. It is not for talk. It is in life. After observing, after experiencing everything, I found I have nothing in my hand. I found I lifted my hand. Swami, you. It's him. Then what is my life? So beautiful. So peaceful. So wonderful. Let everything come and go. Every day look at everything will happen in life. Say this is happening, this will also go. It will be something else. Every day you will feel something new. Everything is blessing of the Lord. If we can think like that, don't stop with bhajans. Don't stop with singing. Go beyond. That is the purpose of bhajans. That is the purpose of Namasmarana. Namasmarana means you have to go beyond. After singing, even if you don't sing, your mind, your heart, everything sings. Once it starts singing and it starts ringing in your mind, nothing else can disturb you. Whether we have achieved that state. After singing 40 years in front of Swami, still you descend. Why don't somebody else sing? 40 years is too much time. One day, one word, if it can go hit the cosmic body and it reflects to you, your life is finished. Why years? Then I told, what's the problem? No, they have put me in chorus singing. I told, very good. No, brother, I was lead singer. I told, what's the problem? No, I was lead singer. I told, how many of them are meeting? Two people there. How many of us are giving chorus? 5,000 people. You belong to powerful group. You belong to power. We should be more happy. I will be more happy instead of, two people will be with me. I won't be happy. Suppose there are 5,000 people with me, I think I am a leader. That's the normal thing. Why we complain when it comes to bhajan? That I am, no, I am in chorus backside and mic is not there. What is that mic? Imagine, human is not valid, mic is valid. So much importance we give to all the other things. Let us give importance wherever we are. I will be more happy when I listen to people. I make others sing. Even as a student, we had the bhajan group, Swami loved me a lot. He will make me sing every day. But I will see to it first. It should be for others. Because when we leave others, when we give space to others, Swami gives us a special place for us. Swami is looking whether we are able to say yes. The other person deserves more than you if you think that you deserve more than anybody else. In God's calculation it is different. That's what I experienced from the time when I went first time to Puttaparthi. I was sitting last. Last near the parapet wall I was sitting. Swami comes for darshan. That's the first day in Prashantanam. Next day college interview. He is coming. And I thought, I am a small 17-year-old boy. So let me just relax and have Swami's darshan. Have the bliss of darshan. And I am sitting last. I thought maybe Swami won't look at me, but I am looking at Swami. When that happiness is there, that is enough. But incidentally, when Swami crossed ladies and came, I am sitting last. Swami calls him. Everyone before me, in front of me, everyone got up. Swami told, because everyone wants him to do. So everyone, Swami with that. And with sadness they also finally thought, me? Oh my God, lost. So we are first when we are lost. Wherever we are, the drishti is there on us. Swami's loving drishti is on us. Never think you are lost in the crowd. You are always noticed, loved and supported in love. This, every time I felt, that time it happened like that. Then Swami's college when I joined, I don't belong to bhajan group. I was a classical violinist. All of you must have heard, I don't want to go into detail of that. Classical violinist. I believed in only classical music, not this type of bhajan. But incidentally now, composed in different scales, different ragas with a mix of the compositions are coming. Once upon a time, pure classical music. If there is one note which is mixing, I think. Later Swami taught me how his name is more sweeter than any Shruti, any Raga. And Swami had given all those things. We are all in such a great thing. Life of every one of us is guided and guarded by Swami. When we have all these things, we don't have to worry about anything. We all should feel that we all belong to class of rishis. We are not ordinary human beings. Otherwise Swami won't address us as embodiment of love. Each one of us should have the conviction that we were all rishis during Rama avatar, Gopikas during Krishna avatar. Each one of us should feel that every Sai devotee. Swami has created this organization. Swami came and stayed in this place in 2010, if I am right. Imagine, he comes all the way and comes on stage here. You know for what? He knows very well that he has to give that love at that last moment with complete blast. He wanted to give the love to Delhi devotees and then go from here. So we have to catch and hold on to that. And each one of us are like the rishis. We are not ordinary human beings with weakness of human beings at all. Each one of us are about everything. This is what I personally feel about Sai devotees. Because I found when Swami was coming by God Darshan, so in the Kulvantrai hall, the last person who is sitting, he will be so happy, blissful in the car. Even friend, Sai students who were sitting in the front, we think, oh my God, Swami didn't look at me. Oh, so I thought today I have a letter and I will give it to Swami. Swami didn't open the window. we'll be thinking like that. Somebody from last in the hall, Kullandal, he comes to a beautiful Darshana Swami. See that satisfaction. See that evolution. See that love. He is able to receive that love. He is able to receive everything. Because he loves Sai's name. He sits in the bhajan. When the bhajan is going on, he doesn't bother who is singing, what is happening. He only knows that Sai Ram name is coming in his ear. And then he feels it is his duty to clap and sing in madness. And he does it. So in between that, if Swami's darshan is also happening, he says, oh, at last, my namasmaranas. You know what? I'm going to have Swami darshan. That wherever he would have seen only the hair of Swami, but he thinks that that is the love which will show Swami in full suit. If that is not there, even Swami comes and stands in front of us, talks to us also, he could have talked to us for more time. He could have called us for interview. Actually, first time my son has come from US and I thought, you know, Swami called me for interview, but then he didn't call. Why? And he has blessed every one of us. So much blessed. Let us, in bhajan, namasmarana, each one of us, because that is the only thing which helped me. When I was studying in the college, I used to sit in music room, students' music room, keep on singing bhajan and keep on. I remember during university exam, Tumma Bin Prani composition. So I want to teach another boy. He said, like, Hari, it is enough if you fail in your exam. Don't disturb me before exam. You understand? Don't disturb me. You want to fail? You fail. But don't disturb. Then I had to, if you are not going to sing this bhajan, I am going to give it to some other boy. My God, you won't allow me to study. Yes, I am coming. Before exam, my warden will say, where is Sai? Either he will be in bhajan music room or he will be sleeping. Before exam day, 8:30, sleep. He comes, hey, tomorrow university exam. Sir, till today I didn't study. One day study won't make any difference. And Swami, that time, exam time, he will give us pen, he will give us Pada Namaskar, he will give us Vibhuti, and he will just send off. When you go to college, he will stand in the veranda, Abhay Hastam, will say, I am writing for you. When he says, I am writing for you, I took it literally, not everyone take it. I am telling, frankly I am telling, I took it literally that Swami is going to write me. If it is fake, then he. If it is past, then he. Nothing to do with me. That's all. I always felt, you know, that's what. And you will not believe, last day, mathematics exam, second paper, I don't know any single word, no question I understood. No question I understood. I thought my duty 1.5 hours I had to sit in the hall. Do your duty properly. Don't think about the result. So sit in the examination hall and I went on writing something. I don't know what I wrote. Not realizing I wrote things like that and then 1.5 hours. Now I can give the paper again. That's all. I told this itself is too much. I don't know which professor was going to correct my paper. I am not bothered because he is writing, he told. So I left it. I always say, Swami, people don't say Hariharan is like this. They say, why Sai Baba is not doing anything to Hariharan? They say, so they are talking about you, not to Hariharan. They are blaming you. Better you take care of yourself, not me. That means he has to take care of me also. Because I am his creation. So exam finished, everything finished exam. I thought, oh, last exam over. We can relax. Evening bhajan, we can go full blast with Swami. So my imagination only that bhajan, 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 namasmarana. Because that love Swami has created that bond with every student. That matters more than your examination. I thought I finished it. I totally forgot. I am coming the most intelligent student in 9 students. Except me, everyone is intelligent. fortunately or unfortunately, all of them score 90 to 100. Out of that, 2-3 people score only 100. They don't know anything less than that. That is their fate. So I can't help it. But they all came out with morose tales. Well, yeah, what happened? Hari, don't you realize anything? I don't know. Everything was fantastic. What do you think about question paper? I told you, it is easy. So I think, very easy. I told you. No man, out of syllabus, they told me. Oh, is that so? Study what? Actually, for me, life itself is out of syllabus. I am telling you. That is how I am able to laugh. That's why I am able to live. Because everything is out of syllabus. Very easy. It makes no difference to me. Whether pass or fail, I am with Swami. What pass and fail? Because in our class, there were some students. In those days, if you fail in exam, and especially if you are a Cinderella, you will have Swami's room duty. So slowly two students said, this time they have to fail. They failed. Then Swami told them, what's your room duty? Then Swami's room duty. Then they were so happy. Because whole day they are in Swami's room duty, morning and evening bhajan, nothing to study, nobody to worry about. So first time Swami. But you have to study when you do your room duty. Because nobody is going to disturb you, you are inside the room, you have to study. They will say, yes, yes. They don't. Because they pass, they have to go out of the room duty. So they fail once, twice, three times. Swami understood, oh. This one has come to this. Swami told me, this time you don't pass, I am sending you out. They went on to get doctorate and all those things later. I don't want to name the people. But what I am trying to say is, sir, either way you gain Swami. If you pass, you are going to study further with Swami. If you fail, you are going to be with Swami himself. So death to fail choice. I thought, no, but they say, you have passed. And later, I told my professor, sir, I didn't write anything. No, you must have written anything. What did you write? I told this first three questions, no, these questions I have come back. They are all out of syllabus, they gave you full mark. Sometimes if you don't know, it gives advantage. So life also, don't take it that serious and morose. Understand, Swami is with you, Swami's name is with you. Bliss of Namasmarana only has given till today everything to me, though I know nothing. If composition comes, composition cannot use it with our new player or put filling words. It don't have emotion. It don't have emotion. You can compose 1,000 songs in a day. When you are alive, you think about Swami, what he has done in his avatarhood, Paramamanohara. And you go to Thiruvannamalai, you get Arunachala Shiva, like that way. And some people, sometimes somebody told, sir, you know, new bhajans like that. Any bhajan is a new bhajan when it was introduced. We got used to bhajans, then it becomes old bhajans. Otherwise, every bhajan is a new bhajan. If I have not heard a bhajan, what you sang today? I have not heard that bhajan. But it's nice to hear. Why should I say this is new bhajan, that is old bhajan? Every bhajan is Swami's bhajan. Born out of love, to be dedicated to Swami, to live in the love of Swami, that bhajans have come. Just accept as it is. To make the crowd sing with you, teach few people. First time it will be difficult. Second time it will be difficult, third time it will be easier, fourth time it will be, fifth time it becomes saral, sixth time you get siddhi over the bhajan, seventh time onwards you live as bhajan. So we will introduce bhajan. What we will do? We will also tell the other singers and then practice. There will be new bhajan. Those times those new bhajans used to be. Now imagine at least students, we could tell students. People like devotees who come with new bhajans because Swami, they want to offer their new bhajans to Swami. And they would have approached us and told, I am going to sing a new bhajan. They come straight, then they sing all devotees that time. One thing I should agree, in those days, every devotee who comes for bhajan will give birth. Every devotee, all will resonate with Swami's name, because they know this is the opportunity to sing in front of Swami. All devotees, they will be sitting and Swami will be here. They will all sing, putting their neck up, and they will sing so that they think that Swami can see them singing. That is the dedication and love. That Namasmarana has to be taken with such enthusiasm. No matter, forget ourselves. And that slowly, from bhajan singing to bhajan realization, composing. Who is composing? Nobody can compose. He gives that situation in your life, he gives that wording, he gives that tuning, he gives that talam, he gives everything. Finally, because Swami thought it, even we should be placed for something useful, because he must rule their ways. How to recognize this fellow? His jobless means nobody will give respect. So he gives. Bless them all with something wonderful. Somebody may be composing bhajans, somebody will be composing music, somebody will do lots of service activities, somebody will take Balvikas class and everything, bring out the children with noble qualities for future international citizens. They were, each one of us do that type of service in Swami's organization. We are the most blessed people in this world. So I pray to Bhagavan to shower his choicest blessing on every one of us, and then we should honor him in the bliss all the time. Bliss is within us with one more bhajan. I'll pray to Swami and then end it.
Shivam bhavatu kalyanam arogyam sukhasampatam dushta buddhi vinashaya dhivipatam namo जप ये साई नाम रात दिन कर ली नयन साई रूप से मिलन कर चरण कमल की कर ले पूरा साई नाथ की कृपा मिल गया तो धन्य तो बन के तू छो बांध प्यार की साईनाथ चंद्रमा की साईनाथ चंद्रमा की ओम पूर्णमद पूर्णमिदं पूर्णा पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ओम शांति शांति शांति।
Sarah brother, thank you so much. It was really very blissful to go through this beautiful session of yours. जब बुली भैया ने मुझसे बोला था कि ये सेशन होगा तो हमने पहले डिस्कस किया कि हम ये सेशन ऑडिटोरियम में करें या भजन हॉल में करें। वी आर सो ग्लैड कि हमने चूज किया कि हम इस सेशन को भजन हॉल में करेंगे, क्योंकि यहाँ पे भजन होता है और जो जो बातें आपने हमें बताई हैं, जितने भी डिवोटीज यहाँ पर हैं, जब भी भजन होगा हम कोशिश करेंगे कि हम स्वामी को याद करके उन टीचिंग्स को अमल करने की पूरी कोशिश करेंगे। There were a few questions which devotees also wanted to ask you. I know we're running short of time. If it is okay, we can probably do maybe a handful of questions. So, especially to bhajan singers who are sitting here, if there are any questions that you would like to ask.
Maybe I'll start. You spoke about Swami asking you to suddenly play the harmonium and you didn't know. So please share that, and more, as there are so many singers, that they can also similarly following that sort of bhava and that sort of practice. Is it possible that those who don't know can actually start playing the harmony?
Exactly, you can. Because I didn't know anything. Suddenly there was no harmony player. Suddenly Swami sent his word through on Divakar Hare Krishna. I went to old hostel, that is the mandir itself, it is there. So we used to live there. Suddenly this boy comes, searches for me and I am not to be found. He went to restrooms and started knocking every door. So finally he came to my room and knocked and he told Swami is calling. Imagine, till then Swami has not talked to you and suddenly somebody is coming and telling you, Swami is calling. How can you believe him? He cannot believe. So I thought, you know, it's just he's playing a trick on me. I told Divakar, I am peaceful here, don't disturb me. Then he told, no. Swami is calling, be serious. He told 2-3 times, then I rushed and Swami was in the veranda. And good singers from Vrindavan, everyone was there. And then Swami said, go play harmony. And I don't know anything ABCD of that. Maximum I can key Sapasa. That I know. I won't say I don't know. So I thought, you know, you cannot tell Swami when he is telling you to play. You cannot tell Swami I don't know. Then he will ask whether I am playing or not. Right? So with that bhavana I went and sat. One by one students asking, man, you know this, you know that. I told I don't know anything. Then why are you sitting here? I told Swami has asked me to play, that's why I'm sitting here. So
Swami will tell, but you should tell, you don't know.
Swami knows everything we say. Then finally we say, Swami physically. This is the problem everywhere it comes. But for me, it is Swami's instruction. I went and sat. So I thought I'm intelligent enough. When they say black too, I'll keep like this. When they start singing, you know, because they told, man, you don't know, don't disturb this song. So I thought, you know, I should at least, you know, if I cannot help them out, at least let me not disturb. Paropakaraya punya papaya prakritam. If you don't help, no problem. At least don't disturb. So I thought I won't disturb them as well. But our Lord is fantastic. He will take his task out in front of public. And those times, fortunately, no microphones. People all know that I am walking with confidence, sitting in front of audience. That's all they know. I say, how lucky this boy is sitting at the lotus feet of Bhagavan. Fortunately, no mic. Otherwise, they will know all my talent, what I am playing. I was sitting. And I used to catch the shuti like this and then this thing. Swami was looking like that, giving a look like that. Then he thought, I am not playing it. If I do what Swami is showing, then will I get this will come. I cannot do anything. He is not allowing me to keep quiet also. From behind the choir sitting. Now, either the command of my brothers or the command of Swami. I took the command of Swami. That's all. When the command of Swami has come, like that 15 days without knowing anything, I disturb the whole village. See the opportunity in front of the Lord. Now we are talking of censure. In front of the Lord, I did like that. And later what happened? After 15 days, Swami came to Vrindavan. He told, you come to Vrindavan. So I thought, okay, I'm going to have darshan. Because in Vrindavan, it's a private session. So I thought, I'm going to have darshan. And I went to and Vrindavan, the still greater thing is, you know, it will be, Swami will be sitting and two, six boys, five, six boys, around 30 students, then around 30 devotees who are very, you know, physically, who does lots of things to Swami, they will be there. So all the more your talent will be out because less crowd. What you play, they will also know. In this condition, and then I should play. Here something happens, not only the voice. First you will be disturbed, because in Puttapu you are on a stage, you are sitting near me, first thing you will be disturbed, and all the other boys, on top of the all the devotees will know my real talent. How can you do this to me? So I was praying and I kept the hand on the arm. It flowed that day, incessantly it flowed. After that, boys came, man, you are a musician, man, you know everything. Why did you not do all these things? I told, man, today it came fluke, tomorrow don't expect this guy. Everything comes like that. He is giving, he is playing. Sai ke haath se badira, sai ki house. If tan tambura tarman hai to, so Sai ki, it's his hand, it is his voice which does through all of us. If we can hold on to that, every one of us can do anything.
Bhagwan Baba ke charno mein koti koti pranam. Hamare priya bhai Hariharan ji ka tay dil se swagat aur dhanyavaad. मैंने भाई हरिहरन को त्रेई वृंदावन में बहुत बड़ी सुना है और ये आज हमारी खुशकिस्मती है कि ये आज हमारे बीच उपस्थित हैं और मैं बड़ा क्वाइटली सुन रहा था उनके मैसेजेस आप सबके लिए स्पेशली जो ये तीन चार लाइन में आगे बैठे हुए हैं सिंगल सम डीप मैसेजेस फ्रॉम हिम टू यू विच आई थिंक यू शुड इम्बाइब इन योर प्रैक्टिस just thanking him and I said, you have done, you've made my job easier. because I think it coming from you makes much more impact than they hearing it from their state president. And I've requested him that he should at least minimum make one yearly trip to Delhi. I am from the powerful group. I clap and I sing no taal, no raag. I do my myself. So I am from the powerful group, and I think others have to work harder to energize us more. Many, many thanks to you.